to make it in. There were 10 virgins, 5 foolish and 5 wise. 5 of them asked the 5 wise, give us some of your oil. And the oil represents the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit of God, and the Word of God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word became flesh, and God was the Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and God was the Word. You know, you may think that that maybe I'm a little too excited for you. Maybe I don't preach exactly the way you like me to preach. Maybe I don't have my suit and my tie on tonight. But you know, there's all kinds of people that make judgments on other people by the way they dress, by the way they make their hair, whether they have the leather jackets on or the boots, they make judgments. Jesus didn't come for the self-righteous. If you're self-righteous and you don't help the guy who's a beggar on the street, you're worthless. Your life is worthless. Jesus said the highest calling is to be your brother's keeper, to help the fatherless, the child who has no father, and the widow. That's one of the highest. Do you know what's on the top of God's hate list? Pride. Pride. God hates pride. There's no way that pride is from God. It's from the evil one. It's from the carnal flesh. And Jesus said, put away the old man. You have to become a new wine bottle filled with new wine. You must become a new wine bottle. You know, I'm not perfect. I'm not a perfect evangelist. You know, I travel all over the country, but I'm in Dallas for a while trying to set up a ranch for children who are sexually abused. And you know, there's very few people that want to help other ministries, very few people. You know, there's people suffering today with depression and mental abuse and sexual abuse from their past, and they don't know how to overcome it, and they still go to church, and they wonder why they're depressed. I suffered with depression until I was 27 years old. And the bottom part of it was I had so much trash in my past, I brought it into the relationship with God when I got saved when I was 17. When I actually realized that Jesus Christ could be real to me, he could be personal. He could be a personal friend who will touch me in the center of my affections. Do you know there's mornings that you may wake up and you may feel lonely and you may turn to the phone and phone your mother up or your girlfriend or your boyfriend and say, you know, start a conversation with them. Why don't you start a conversation with Jesus Christ when you wake up in the morning? Why don't you build a relationship with Christ? I mean, nothing else in this world matters. It don't matter how much money you got in the bank. It doesn't matter. Nothing matters in this life unless your soul's saved and you're going to heaven. That's the only thing that matters today. Nothing else. It don't matter how big or how hot shot you think you are for the executive for IBM. I mean, give me a break. What you do for a living has got nothing to do with what really matters to God. God said he chose the foolish things of this world to confound the wise. Do you know if you're an intellectual, you'll probably end up in hell for it? Because God doesn't show himself to the arrogant and proud. He shows himself to broken vessels. He said you must become as a child. If you don't surrender your will to him, there's no way you're going to make it in. No way. You think you're going to heaven and you think you're saved just because you put your name on the church ballot? Going to church don't save your soul. You have to build a personal relationship with the one we're talking about who has the key to the gate. Remember the 10 virgins? 5 of them went to hell. Do you remember the story of the other man, Lazarus' brother or friend? He was in hell, and he was crying out to Lazarus for a drop of water. And Lazarus said, I'm sorry, I can't come down there. You passed over. You know, 3 years ago, I was one of the top beauty consultants in Canada. I had one of the most successful beauty salons in Ottawa, the capital of Canada. God told me 3 years ago, 2.5 to 3 years ago, to walk away from my business and called me into full-time ministry for him. And I've been working with street people for 15 years. I did my business part-time. And I did the ministry part-time. But you know, every time I go to church, I always run across these people that try to tell me how to live my life. And if you want to tell me how to live my life, it better line up with the Word of God or shut your mouth. If it's not in the Word of God, don't try to tell me how to live my life and how to interpret the Scriptures, because that's not even biblical. The Bible says to work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Work out your own salvation. People don't even read their Bible, for heaven's sakes. They go to church on Sunday and they think they're just doing God a big favor. And they put $2 in the offering plate and they think everything's just cool. Well, you're nuts, my friend. You're totally lost it if you believe that. Because that's not even biblical. God's heart is to help people and love other people. And this book says if you don't have love for your neighbor and you don't have love for yourself, how can you have the love of God? How can you do what Jesus... He cursed the fig tree because it didn't bear forth fruit. He cursed it. And you know he curses people today if they do not bear forth fruit. Do you remember the story of the talents? Three guys. Three servants of the master. One was given one talent, one two, and one three. The first one buried his talent in the ground. Jesus used this as a parable. He went away and he buried his talent in the ground. The money of that day, the coin. The second guy, he had two talents. He multiplied the two talents to five. The Bible says his master was pleased. The third servant, he had three talents, he multiplied it to 10 talents. So many months later, the master comes back and he says, what did you do with what I gave you? How much fruit did you bear? And the one servant said, well, I was afraid, so I buried it in the ground so I wouldn't lose it. The second one said, well, master, I multiplied the seed that you gave me. The fruit that you gave me, the knowledge that you gave me, the love that you gave me, I gave it away. And I multiplied it. I brought back five. And the master said, I appreciate you. I love you for that. The third servant, he took the three talents that he had and he multiplied them to 10. And he came back to his master and his master said, I love you so much, my servant. I love you because you did what you're supposed to do. You didn't just sit at home every night after work and do nothing to help other people. You know, a lot of people, after they work 8 hours, come home and give their wife a big pity party on how hard they worked all day. Well, poor you. You're supposed to make money to pay for the bills of your family. And the Bible says, if you don't provide for your family, you're worse than a defiled person. You're worse than that. It also says, if you don't work, you don't deserve to eat. Do you know the world's full of lazy people today? They want something for nothing. People come into the relationship with Jesus Christ and expect God to knock them on the head and say, follow me. And God doesn't do that. He said, if you want him, you need to ask him in. If you don't ask, you don't receive. If you don't knock at the door doesn't get open to you. If you don't seek, you don't find. You must build a relationship with him. It's not enough to go to the altar. And you may not like the way I preach it, but that's too bad. You have to answer to God, because I'm speaking right out of the Word, and my heart's right. I don't know about yours, but mine is. I mean, we're talking about life and death here. We're not playing little games. You know, there's a child within you if you're an adult. There's a child that you need to get in touch with. You're not just a spiritual being. You're a fleshly being, you're a psychological being. You know, a lot of people, they bring their past pain into their relationship with Jesus Christ. You know, there's a lot of single people today that are looking for someone to love. And they think, well, if I can just find a woman, or I can find a man, a boyfriend or a girlfriend, everything's going to be just peaches and cream. No, it's not. You're a fool if you think that. Because number one, you must come face to face with Jesus Christ. You don't know what love is until you come face to face with the Prince of Peace. He's the one who gives peace. He's the one who sets homosexuals free. Leviticus Genesis 18:22 says, a man shall not lie with another man. It's an abomination before the living God. I was sexually abused by homosexuals from 5 to 12 years old, and I'm not the least bit ashamed of it. I couldn't help what happened to me when I was a child, but I grew up being suicidal because the men that touched me when I was a child, I couldn't do anything about it. They kept the whole, I would complain to my mother, and you know, she kicked one boarder out. We'd get another one, he'd do the same thing to me. And then my mother left me when I was 11 years old, put me in a foster home. She didn't feel like she wanted me anymore, and I'm the youngest of 9 children. And my father died when I was 2 years old. And there's 6 boys and 3 girls in my family. My mother raised us to make us feel like we owed her something for being born because my father died on her. She ended up marrying an alcoholic. And this alcoholic tried to ruin our lives for about 7 or 8 years. And my brothers are pretty tough guys. And, you know, it's amazing when the devil wants to plant sin. You know, the Bible says what you sow is what you're going to reap. So if you sow sin into your children, if you don't treat your children properly, if you don't spend time with them, if you don't teach them to read, if you don't raise them with discipline, you know, a lot of parents won't even spank their children. Oh, I can't spank my child because it's going to affect his mind when he's an adult. Lady, it's going to affect him more if you don't discipline him now.